Hello everyone, welcome again to my channel. I'm Archana Singh. In this video lecture, I'm going to discuss about recently asked questions which were asked in September 2020 exam from linguistics and literary theory. I have already uploaded one more video, so you can check this video, and this is part 2. Okay, in this video also we will discuss questions which were asked in September 2020 exam from linguistics and literary theory. So let's start. So very first question is match list 1 with list 2. Okay, so please check the options and try to match. Here the right answer is option number 2. Paul Grice has given a term cooperative principles, and Edward Sapir has given the term linguistic relativity. Ferdinand de Saussure given the term linguistic science, and Nancy Dorian has written a book Language Zit. Okay, so here the right answer will be option number 2. Paul Grice has given the term cooperative principles, and in this term he said that in social science generally and linguistics specifically, the cooperative principles describes how people achieve effective conversational communication in common social situations. And in this order, he gives maxims of conversation, the principle of effective communication. There are 4 maxims: maxims of quantity, maxims of quality, maxim of relation, and maxims of manner. Okay, and linguistic relativity is a term given by Sapir, and the theory of linguistic relativity states that the structure of language influences the way its speaker conceptualizes the world. Swiss linguist Ferdinand de Saussure described the sign and its arbitrary relations to reality, and Nancy has written a book Language Zit, the life cycle of a Scottish Gaelic dialect. The next question is given below are 2 statements. One is assertion and the other is reason. So assertion is sign are never neutral or innocent, and the reason is in all cases signs are organized into system that conveys some meaning. And here the right answer will be option number A. Both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. The next question is terms and theories you have to match, another match type questions, and you have to match the terms with the theories. So please check the options and try to answer which one will be the correct answer. Arc writing is a term used by French philosopher Jacques Derrida in his attempt to reorient the relationship between speech and writing. A Cyborg Manifesto is an essay written by Donna Haraway, and in this manifesto criticized traditional notions of feminism. Particularly feminist focus on identity politics. She uses the figure of the cyborg to urge feminists to move beyond the limitation of traditional gender, feminism and politics. And this manifesto is considered one of the milestone in development of feminist post-humanist theory. Okay, post-humanist theory of feminist. Transferring the focus to text, Julia Kristeva offers the term genotext and phenotext. Kristeva is primarily known for a term which she given intertextuality. Okay, intertextuality. When we realize that meaning is not transferred directly from writer to reader, but instead is mediated through or filtered by code. And the last one is hermeneutic circles is a term given by German writer Friedrich Schleiermacher. Okay. So here here the right answer is option number A. Acrature is a term by Jack Derrida. Cyborg by Donna Haraway. Gynotics by Julia Kristeva. And hermeneutics circles by Frederick Schleiermacher. Next question is, who among the following feminist theorists posited a separate realm of female experience captured in a style of writing different from men's? Okay, so here, which one will be the correct answer? All the feminist writers has been given, and the question is asking that which feminist writers has posited a separate realms of female experience captured in a style of writing different from men. Okay. Helen Sixers was a French feminist, and she given a term écriture féminine or women writing, and this term she coined in her essay The Laugh of Medusa. Okay, The Laugh of Medusa, and Sixer aimed to establish a genre of literary writing that deviates from traditional masculine style of writings. Okay, and the Louise is a French feminist, and she examined the use and misuse of language in relation to women. So the right answer is Helen Sixer and Louise Erigre. So the right answer will be option number 4. Okay. Now come to the next question. Next question is again match type question. We have to match list 1 to list 2. So now try to answer. Here the right answer is option number 3. Michael Ricardo has given the text The Practice of Everyday Life. John Fiske has given the text Understanding Popular Culture. Pierre Bardot has text Distinction. And Janice Radway is given the text Reading the Romance. Okay, so here the right answer is option number 3. You can check here the explanation. Okay. Now come to the next question. Next question is again a match type question, and we have to match the term with theorist. Okay, so please try to answer. Here the right answer is option number 2. Right, option number 2 is right answer. Okay, super reader is a term coined by Michael Refetri, and biopower is a term coined by Michael Foucault. Biopower is a time term by Michael Foucault. And bricolage is a term by Claude Lévi-Strauss. And chronotope is a term by Mikhail Bakhtin. So all the terms are important. You have to keep in mind that the term and theorist. Once again, I'm going to repeat. Okay, super reader is a term by Michael Refetri, and biopower is a term by Michel Foucault, and bricolage is a term by Claude Lévi-Strauss, and chronotope is a term by Mikhail Bakhtin. Okay, so the right answer is option number 2. Next question is, which two terms from among the following are specifically linked to the work of Pierre Bourdieu? Here the right answer is Option number A and D. In previous questions, we have discussed about distinction, that a term by fair value, and in this the next question in the same year's questions asked with the same writers. So here the right answer is option number A and D. Option number 2 is right answer. Okay, so theory of habitus is a term by fair value, and it a theory of action. The next question is, which two of the following statements are applicable to meta language? So please check the options and try to answer. Here the right answer is option number 3. Meta language, a technical language which describes the property of language, and meta language is a second order of language. So right answer is option number 3. In logic and linguistics, meta language is a language used to describe another language, often called the object language. Okay. The next question is, which of these statements describe correctly the basic assumptions of structuralism? Okay, so please check the options and try to answer which one will be correct. So here the right answer is option number 2. So a structuralism is concerned with sign and signification. It is true. Structuralist theory consider only verbal conventions and code. It is not true. Structuralism began in the work of Jack Derrida. No, it's not true. It begins with Ferdinand de Saussure. And structuralism challenges the long-standing belief that literature reflects a given reality. It is true. And all signs are arbitrary, but without them we cannot comprehend reality. It is true. So the option number A, D and E. So option number 2 is right answer. The next question is, which one of the following best explain the term paralanguage? Okay, so please check the options and try to answer. Here the right answer is option number 2. The way in which people choose what they mean other than by the words they use. Okay, that is called paralanguage. Paralanguage is non-verbal communication such as your tone, pitch or manner of speaking. Okay, it is a non-verbal. Paralanguage is a non-verbal communication.